I'm in Derbyshire today. I'm just going out for a day walk. And I've come down off the top because it's misty and flaggy. I'm a place called Middleton, near Yulgrave, which is between Bakewell and Matlock in the White Derbyshire Peak. And I'm going to set up a little pit stop for and shelter for to have a cup of coffee and a bite of banana and some nuts and raisins. So I shall get started. It's quite warm today. We have had some frost, but as you can see today on my little sun tour there, you can see that 10 degrees, and barometric pressure just under 983 under 1,000. So there's this little, this is called Bradford Dale, and it's a beautiful little, I've been here before. It's a nice little valley where either side, rocks either side, river running down the middle. Obviously a former industrial site with all these walls and what have you. Yeah, as you can see, it's quite claggy, as we call it, or those who don't understand claggy, northern dialect, it's misty or fog or low cloud. And on the tops, the visibility is down to about 25 metres, I would say. 25 metres, 25 yards, same difference. Right, I shall get on. There's my trusty day pack. I've got everything in there I need. I've got poncho and I've got a stove, which I'm field testing for the first time. It's the one with a Stanley Cook Pot, but I've modified it. I've done a few more changes to it. And I've had mess in it, but I'm going to burn some wood in it so that it'll burn the plastic off thoroughly. And I want to get it really heated up, burn any deposits off, and then what I shall do when I get home is I'll spray it with the black enamel, not enamel, but stove paint, which will take high temperature, which will stop it from rusting and prolong its life. Right, so I'm going to get set up a little shelter, because it is sort of mildly drizzling, as it were, and it's dripping down from the trees, so I might as well have a bit of shelter. I'll bimble about here for about half an hour, three quarters of an hour or so. Right, I'll set up better still than that. Quickly done. Just four bungee cords and the old USGI poncho. I've got another poncho with me, which if I want to night out, I'd use that as a sleeping bag cover, but it's a lot more lightweight than this one. Or it works as a ground sheet. Just an emergency shelter, really. I've got poncho liner with me. That would be the clothing, would keep me reasonably warm overnight, although it has been down to zero and a little bit below this week. Handy sit mat, fold up sit mat, the Stanley Cook Pot with the new stove, coffee and sugar mixed up. I mean, I'm on instant today again, but I've got some in the pot which I would use if I was camping out. And as you can see, there's a plentiful supply of wood lying about. The difficulty is finding a bit that's dry. I might have to use a bit of mess to get it going, but I'm sure we've all been there. And down here the water looks pretty clean to me, although I have got water with me and I'll use that. If I was stuck, just boil a bit of that up, I'm sure it'll be alright. Because around here there's very little arable farming, so it's the only fertiliser that goes down the ground is natural animal fertiliser. So there's no insecticides or out like that that's going to be draining off the land anyway. And to be perfectly frank, I've walked in the for the best part of 40 years, and when you get above a few thousand, you know, 1,500 feet, somewhere around that level, there's no farming up there anyway, so take the water off the from the streams, I've never had a problem. You get all this tailed dead sheep in the water and stuff like that. Oh, never had a problem, never had a bad belly, anything like that. And plus, if you boil it, you're going to be safe anyway, aren't you? Right, I'll set up the old stove and get it going and get the brew on. Or first of all, I might as well show you the modification before I get it going of what I've done to it. There we go. Right, I've no tripod with me today, so I'm going to rest this between my knees and hopefully you can see what I'm doing. Trangia handle, again, which is I found it comes in handy, mini Trangia handle. The difference is this time, I've made it, probably just getting a bit of my trouser leg there, with a different bottom. You see this comes out and it's removable. So this I cut out with my Swiss Army knife, so you could make this stove up with a knife, no problem at all. As you can see, I put vents in it to make the air swirl a bit more around it. I just marked it out with a Sharpie and felt it pen, whatever, and just chopped it out. So the reason being is, I'll just put the camera down a sec while I do this. I might be able to use it as a bit of a tripod. So, reason being is now I mount the Trangia burner in there. Yeah. So that effectively is just a windshield plus a pot mount. But to put it out or whatever, it's a lot easier to do this, you know. Then you can snuff it out, put it onto simmer. I don't think you can see that one. Right, sorry about that. Right, as you can see, I put the Trangia burner in there. The two wire pot supports go through the holes, and that's at the right height, same as the mini Trangia. That's how I measured it from that to get the right height. So the Trangia goes in there. This is a windshield. You could cut those holes out with a knife. I've just done it with a step with the reamer on a Swiss Army knife. I've just done it with a step drill. The reason being is I can put a bigger pot on top of that and the flames can get out and it can aerate through the sides. You could use a church key, can opener, anything like that, or even just cut out triangles with your knife. It's if you've got a decent knife, it's easy enough to do. Right. Oh, before I go any further, this will be going in the bottom because I'm burning wood, and of course because that's there, that will keep the heat from the floor, from the ground, and also collect any ash inside there, so it's nice and tidy. That is just a sweet tin that just slots in the bottom there very nicely. Now in the Trangia, in the Stanley Cook set, sorry, I've also made this little thing. It was actually a top for another store, but I just adapted it. And what happens is the Trangia burner slots in that, and that when I'm using it as a mess stove, it keeps it in the middle, centralised inside there. But we're not using that today. We're going to burn some wood. As you can see, this has still got the plastic inside it, and the heat of the mess stove hasn't been enough to melt it all off, so I really want to get it hot and get that burnt off, and then I'll spray it up with the stove paint, or exhaust paint will work. As I said, the car exhaust paint, high temperature. Right, I'll stop now and I'll start again when I've got it burning.
There we are,
we're going. Just put a bit of water in my pot, just enough for a cup. I'll bung that on. I'm not going to time it or anything, but I think that'll be enough to do that bit. So there she is in full swing. And yeah, I'm quite pleased with that. I'm getting a bit of smoke in the eyes, so I had to move from my seat. A common problem. There we go. And we've got some lunch in here as well. I'll just get it unzipped. Nice banana. Oh, that's my other poncho. As you can see, a lot lighter weight, but it's good for just sticking over your top. Come out on some nuts and raisins for later. Right. Well, I'm sure I won't bore you with how long it takes to boil, but it will do it, I'm sure. And I shall have my cup of coffee. So, signing off from Bradford Dale in the Derbyshire White Peak District. I shall now enjoy my cup of coffee and my unsociable cigarette. Although I've probably breathed a load of smoke with it being wet wood. It's got me in the eyes a little bit, but now it's working good. Once it's dried out, it's fine. So the secret of that is obviously to get your wood as dry as possible. It only did a little bit of mess as well, it wasn't too bad. I had some tissues in my pocket and so I bung rolls in. And it was pretty ready to light. Yeah. Anyway, as I've said before, if you're worried about slutting on your pots, that will cover it up anyway. But if you don't like it, then just wait till your bits of wood have gone down to embers and you'll still get enough to boil up for a coffee or whatever. So that way you avoid slutting your pans. But it is also to be noted, I think I've said before, that blackened pans are better to have because they absorb the heat better from the fire. So unless you really, really want shiny pots, I suggest you don't clean them, just wipe the soot off with a tissue or whatever. Give them a wash in soapy water to get the rest of it off, and then you're good to go again and leave what blacking that remains on the pot there for next time. It works. Trust me. Bye for now.